Meanwhile, Cleveland city leaders are trying to reassure the public that the risk of catching Ebola is extremely small. Yet the mayor says city officials are taking precautions to keep Clevelanders and all of you safe. Kevin Freeman attended a news conference at about 2 o'clock this afternoon. He joins us live from City Hall with an update on that. Kevin?
Well, Gabe, Mayor Jackson said that he wants to let the public know first and foremost that there are no known cases of Ebola here in Cleveland. But that being said, the city has activated its emergency command center to make sure that city leaders stay on top of this situation. Now, the mayor also said today at this 2 o'clock news conference that they learned about Amber Vinson's visit to Cleveland just after 6 o'clock this morning. He says officials waited to speak publicly about it until after they spoke with CDC officials and gathered all local information to put out to the public accurately. Now, the director of Cleveland's health department says that the emergency command center was activated so they can stay on top of any new information they receive. They say city leaders say that their main goal right now is to protect the public, contain any potential outbreak, and to respond properly if there happens to be one. Now, she also says that local health departments and hospitals, they are ready on standby just in case. She reminds people that Ebola can only be spread through direct contact with a person's bodily fluids, not through the air. Hopkins Airport Director Ricky Smith was also there, and he says that certain areas of the airport will be disinfected purely as a precaution.
We are taking precautionary measures to intensify our cleaning of key facilities related to that hold room, that jetway, and we're also educating our workforce on measures that they can take to make sure that they're constantly protected from this kind of exposure.
Now, city leaders say that they have had 3 to 4 conference calls this morning with members of the CDC. They also say the assistant safety director says that if someone calls 911, now keep in mind flu season is coming up and many of the symptoms can be similar, but if someone calls 911 and they have possible Ebola symptoms, they're going to ask that person further questions such as where they've traveled from. If for some reason that they believe that person could have Ebola, they will still send an ambulance, but they will alert the ambulance drivers, the first responders, let them know that they need to dress accordingly, dress appropriately in order to handle that situation just in case. We also asked whether Amber had been anywhere in Cleveland while she was here. We know she was visiting family in Akron. They say right now they have no reason to believe she made other stops here in Cleveland, but they say they're in contact with the CDC. They'll be the ones directly interviewing her to know exactly whether she stopped other places in the city.
Very interesting stuff there, Kevin. You know that they talked about the technology in place, so when a 911 call does come in, they are going to ask, as they put, special questions. I thought that was fascinating, and yet they will continue on and dispatch, as you say, an ambulance right to pick them up.
Right, the ambulance will still come, but they'll alert the first responders just so they know what they're getting into or possibly getting into.
But again, to reiterate, no cases, no Ebola cases in Akron,
no
Canton,
cases.
Cleveland, no cases as of now. All right.